Here we explain the difference in relative sizes of plug flow reactors and continuous stirred tank reactors. And we're going to look at the case for isothermal reaction. We don't have to look at specific kinetics. We're just going to look at this graphical representation. And if we look at reaction at a conversion of 60%, so the outlet concentration here is 4/10 of the inlet concentration. And notice the concentration, this is zero in the reactor, this is the feed concentration. As the concentration reactor decreases, of course, the rate decreases, so this 1 over the rate increases. But from our mass balances, the volume is proportional to this area. So I've written the mass balance for CSTR in a form so it's easy to visualize. This, of course, is the y-axis, 1 over the rate for a general nth order reaction. This is the volumetric flow rate in the reactor. And this is the concentration difference, the inlet minus the outlet concentration. So this is the x-axis. And you can see the x-axis times y-axis, this is the area. This area, cross that area then, is proportional to the reactor volume for a CSTR. What we want to compare that to is the reactor volume for a plug flow reactor. So for a plug flow reactor, this is the mass balance of plug flow reactor, the change in the molar flow rate, this is the molar flow rate moving down the reactor, as a function of cumulative volume, again, is related to the rate of reaction here. This nth order reaction. We can rearrange so that the volume, this is just the area under the curve, which is the area under that 1 over the rate of reaction, a minus sign, right? This is the rate of reaction. So this means we can look at this same graph and look at what the plug flow reactor volume is. And so the plug flow reactor volume to get to the same conversion would be this area. And notice it's a much smaller area. And of course, as the conversion gets higher, the difference between the plug flow and the CSTR volumes increases even more, because we're always running that CSTR at that final conversion. However, we get the advantage of the higher concentrations for the plug flow reactor. So to get to much higher conversion, plug flow reactor to 90% conversion, now this total area that's in red would represent the volume for plug flow reactor to 90% conversion. The other thing to notice is that whether we have one reactor or two reactors, two plug flow reactors in series, if their volumes are the same, the conversions are the same. Remember, everything here is isothermal. Because this integral, this area under the curve, there is no inherent advantage to having two plug flow reactors in series. But there's a significant advantage for 90% conversion, for example, of having two CSTRs in series, so that the second CSTR be this blue hatched area, whereas if we had just one CSTR, we'd have a much bigger area. One CSTR would require this area that's in green, so much larger for one CSTR than two. Plug flow reactors, the sum is the same whether it's one or two plug flow reactors in series.